Friday was the last day of filing nominations in both the states. The scrutiny of nominations will be done on Saturday, and candidates can withdraw their candidature by Monday. Let's first get you all the updates from Maharashtra. On the last day of filing nominations, Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis filed his nomination from Southwest Nagpur Assembly constituency. The Congress had on Thursday announced the nomination of former BJP MLA Ashish Deshmukh from the Southwest Nagpur seat. So far, a total of 1,969 nominations have been filed from across the state for the 288-member state assembly.
जिस प्रकार की एक सकारात्मक लहर है इसके चलते निश्चित रूप से भारतीय जनता पार्टी शिवसेना रिपाई ये जो हमारी एक बड़ी युति है ग्रैंड अलायंस है ये बहुत अच्छे वोटों से जीतेगा एक रिकॉर्ड जीत हम हासिल करेंगे बड़े पैमाने पर हम लोग महाराष्ट्र में भी सीटें जीतेंगे और नागपुर जहां से मैं लड़ रहा हूं शहर की 6 और जिले की 6 ऐसी 12 की 12 सीटें हम जीतेंगे एक अभूतपूर्व विजय मिलेगी
Several political bigwigs filed nominations on Thursday. BJP State President Chandrakant Patil filed papers from Coats Road in Pune. The others included Shiv Sena's Eknath Shinde and NCP leader Ajit Pawar. Sitting NCP MLA Jitendra Abhad also filed his papers from the Kalwa Mumbra constituency in Thane. In the state of Maharashtra, there are several key issues, including severe drought and agrarian distress, that are likely to dominate the political scenario this time. In these elections, while the opposition parties are trying to corner the government on these very issues, the BJP on its part is highlighting its development agenda. In this report, let's take a look at the key issues that Maharashtra will vote on this time.
Maharashtra will be the first state to have elections after the BJP's thumping victory in the Lok Sabha polls. While the BJP is highlighting its development agenda, the opposition is focusing on the job crisis and farmers' issues to corner the government. The severe drought, agrarian distress, farmer suicides, unemployment and also the demands for reservation are likely to dominate the campaign during the upcoming assembly polls. Given that nearly 50% geographical area of the state is witnessing drought as well as a water crisis, addressing the resentment in rural areas will be a major issue for the BJP-led government. The BJP Shiv Sena Alliance government led by Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis has so far extended a relief of nearly 10,000 crore rupees. The opposition Congress NCP front, however, claims that the Jalyukt Shivir Abhiyan, the flagship scheme of the CM to make the state drought-free, has not yielded any results. According to reports, in the last 4 years, more than 12,000 farmers have committed suicides.
You see, as far as Maharashtra is concerned, there are many issues. If we talk of ruling party or ruling alliance of BJP and Shiv Sena and the government, obviously they have their agenda of development, progress, what they have done to the farmers, then waiver especially, and other issues. Because Maharashtra, though it's a very progressive state and industrious state, but despite that, Maharashtra is also agriculturally very important state, because Maharashtra's economy waves around sugar cane, onion. So these are also the lobbies in Maharashtra, which actually influence politics.
Besides this, reservation is another issue for the BJP government to tackle with. The Marathas account for nearly 33% of the total 11.25 crore population of Maharashtra. On one ground, that the state succeeded is giving 16% reservation to Marathas in jobs and education. Thus, Maratha now has a 68% quota above the 50% mandated by the Supreme Court. Now, there is a demand from other communities like Muslim to provide reservation in jobs. Besides Dhangar, the Shepherd community are demanding reservation.
This government has taken initiative to have metros for urban transport, like Mumbai. Mumbai has a very best network of urban transportation. So, on those lines, government has taken certain steps to provide urban and civic infrastructure, facilities, amenities to the urban population also.
Since coming to power, the BJP's biggest priority has been infrastructure, particularly transport. This has translated into projects such as new metro lines for Mumbai, Pune, Nagpur, and the Mumbai-Nagpur Samruddhi Expressway, besides the center's ambitious bullet train. Several state highways have also been upgraded. Another issue that the opposition parties have been hammering at the government is the issue of price rise and inflation. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And let's now get you all the news and updates from the election battleground in Haryana. On the last day of filing nominations in Haryana, Congress leader Bhupender Singh Hooda filed his nomination from Gadhi Sampla Kiloi seat. The senior Congress leader, who is also leading the Congress party's election campaign in the state, claimed the BJP government in Haryana will be ousted after the 21st October polls, as people have made up their mind to bring back the main opposition party to power. The Haryana Congress Legislature Party leader said the false promises made by the BJP have been exposed in front of the people.
मैं समझता हूं कि आज से हरियाणा में बदलाव का बिगुल बज चुका है चौधरी उपेंद्र सिंह हुड्डा जी ने नामांकन पत्र भरा है हुड्डा साहब के हाथ में जब से कांग्रेस के चुनाव की कमान आई है तब से मैं समझता हूं प्रदेश के अंदर दिन प्रतिदिन कांग्रेस पार्टी का ग्राफ बढ़ा है शैलजा जी को अध्यक्ष बनाया गया है और इस नेतृत्व में हुड्डा साहब के नेतृत्व में शैलजा जी के नेतृत्व में कांग्रेस पार्टी प्रदेश के अंदर एक सकारात्मक विकल्प और बदलाव लेके कांग्रेस पार्टी आएगी.
One of BJP's star candidates, wrestler Yogeshwar Dutt, also filed his nomination from Baroda seat in Haryana. He was accompanied by Union Sports Minister Kiran Rijiju as he filed his papers.
मेरा ये है कि मैं लोगों की सेवा करूं और जो प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी का जो सपना है सशक्त भारत का और सबका साथ सबका विकास उसको लेके आगे चलेंगे जो ईमानदारी हमारी मनोहरलाल खट्टर जी ने जो यहां पे दिखाई है उसको लेके आगे चलेंगे.
With the opposition parties in disarray and the Modi factor still in play, the BJP looks to maintain its edge over its contenders in Haryana. Manoharlal Khattar, Haryana's first BJP chief minister, has said that the implementation of central government schemes in the state is going to win them the people's confidence one more time. The Haryana government has done well in registering almost 1.4 million farmers under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Nidhi, out of which nearly 30% have received the third installment of 6,000 rupees relief given to eligible farmers per year. The chief minister has also made NRC implementation a poll promise in the state this time. So while the BJP is wooing farmers with government benefits and schemes, the Congress and other opposition parties like the INLD and the JJP are also offering loan waivers, free electricity and monthly stipends to the youth.